Hello everyone, Peter here from Videobolt, with a quick guide to making an awesome lyric video. Lyric videos have been popping up on YouTube for over a decade now, though their popularity is only growing, often overshadowing their music video counterparts. It used to take ages to make a lyric video, but here I'll show you how to do it in less than half an hour with Videobolt. All you need is a song and lyrics, and you can make something like what you see on screen right now. Let's dive in! The first thing to do is pick one of Videobolt lyric templates. These are highly customizable and serve as a stylistic basis for your own video. I'll be making a video for the song Golden by Outwild and She Is Jules. To go with it, I'll adapt the Universe lyrics template. By default, it features a dark blue space background, though something with a more golden, amber tint would fit my song better. I could adjust the space colorization manually. Instead, I'll just pick the Helix theme and click Apply. Now that I've picked my template and theme, I should go ahead and upload the song and time the lyrics. I don't have an SRT file on hand, but I do have the lyrics to the song, and I can time that easily from inside the Videobolt editor. First, you need to add the song. Click the track placeholder and then select an import option. I'll get my song directly from SoundCloud by pasting the link. Now, I can click Add Lyrics to do exactly that. I have options here to use an SRT file or lyrics I've previously made on my Videobolt account. But I'm starting from scratch, so I'll click Create Lyrics. The text box which appears is where you paste the lyrics. Then click the button to get to the lyric editor. In the lyric editor, I can see all the lines of my lyrics on the left-hand side and the timeline on the right. The lyrics have been placed in the second half of the song, which you can see when you zoom out the timeline with the scroll wheel. Having them placed like this makes it easier for me to synchronize the lyrics as I listen to the song. Speaking of which, let's introduce two essential keyboard shortcuts, Q and E. Pressing Q will bring the next line of lyrics to the current time, while pressing E will adjust when the selected line ends. Using the pair of them, you can sit back, listen to your song, and hit Q every time a line of lyrics comes in, and then hit E when that line ends. I'll just go ahead and do a sped up first run of this whole song. And now that I've set up my initial timings, I should save my work, so I don't accidentally lose it due to a page refresh or something similar. When saving the file, you'll be prompted to name it. I'll just use the name of my song and artist. After saving, I can do another pass to fix any minor inconsistencies and add additional emphasis by separating some lines and words. To help me with this, I have two options in my toolbar, separate by line and separate by word. I'll use these on a few lines at the start of the song. The toolbar also holds the options to quickly add, delete, and merge lines of lyrics. With everything well set up, it's time to save again. Since the lyrics file has already been created, I'm asked if I want to create a new file or overwrite the existing one. In this case, I'll go with overwrite. After saving, you can close the lyric editor and check the preview. Preview videos are generated automatically when you make a change, so there should be one in progress as you close the lyric editor. Once the preview is done, check to make sure everything is the way you intended. Looking at my preview, I would like to change the font and increase the text size. In order to change the font and text size, I'll head over to the Customize tab in the sidebar. Then click the font placeholder to pick one. I can choose a Google font or something custom I have on my computer. I'll go with a Google font, Bungee Shade. To make the text bigger, I'll set the font size to 128 pixels. The default is 64 pixels, so this is double the size. You can try out any size you like. Behind the scenes, the system makes sure text never grows outside the screen. Additionally, I'd like to change the color of the lyrics to a gradient between white and gold, so it matches the theme of the song. To do this, I'll switch to Advanced Controls and expand the text formatting group. Then, click the Text Color mode and change the dropdown to Gradient. In order to set the colors of my gradient, I'll change Text Color End to a gold color. Text color start sets the other color in the gradient, but I'll leave it as is, since white is the default. With one last check of the preview, I'm ready to render my final high-resolution video by clicking Produce and Download. This template has a lot of complex calculations in the background, so the rendering process will take some time, and you can always close the tab and you'll get an email when the video is done. You can also find the video on the My Videos page. Let's speed this up to show you the final result. That's all it takes to make an awesome lyric video. If you want, you can even take it a step further and combine it with one of Videobolt music visualizers to have even more elements on screen that react to the music. Here, I combined my golden lyric video with the ripped cover visualizer, and you've just seen this process at breakneck speeds. Check out my previous video on combining visualizers for a more detailed guide. For now, let's just take a look at the result. Not the generic lyric video we're all used to, right? I hope this guide helped you make an awesome lyric video. We'd love to feature the best vids on our social pages, so feel free to share a link on Twitter and make sure you mention VideoBoltNet. Stay tuned for further tips, tricks, and other video making guides. Have a great day, see you soon.